everyone. Welcome to Let's DevOps. I am Sumit, and in this video, we will learn GitLab YAML pipeline. Further, we will also set up multi-stage, multi-job CI/CD pipeline. So for all the discussion and demo, I'll be following this article. You can find the link of this article in video description. So let's start. So in this blog, we will learn the basic of GitLab YAML pipeline, and further, we will learn to set up the CI/CD. Coming to the demo, so for the demo, we will use these three use cases. In the first use case, we will set up a multi-stage, multi-job pipeline. In the second, we will set up a pipeline with the variables. And in the third, we will build a Visual Studio projects. Okay. Now coming to YAML. So YAML, you might be already knowing, is a human readable data serialization language, and it helps to configure a pipeline as a code. Indentation is very important in YAML. Coming to the GitLab YAML pipeline, in GitLab, YAML pipeline helps to set up the CI/CD. So through that YAML only, we can set up our pipeline. We don't have any other option. Like in Azure DevOps, we have two different options, right? One is through that setting up your pipeline using classic editor and also with the YAML. But in GitLab, you have only YAML through which you can set up your pipeline, your CI/CD pipeline. Now let's discuss the structure of GitLab YAML pipeline. In GitLab, you can define your pipeline with extension .yaml, .gitlab-ci.yaml. And under that YAML, you can see list of stages defined. And under the stages, you'll define this jobs. And under the jobs, you define the script. So basically, whenever you open a YAML file, mainly you will see stages. Under the stages, you will see the jobs. And under the jobs, you'll see the script. Coming to the hierarchy of YAML pipeline file, in YAML pipeline file, you'll have first stages defined. Under the stages, you'll have a job defined. Under the job, you have a script defined. So let's see, this is one of the sample pipeline file where we have defined three different stages. And then also we have defined three different jobs. Each job is associated with a stage. You cannot have a job without a stage. And under each job, you can see there is a script defined. So under the script section only, you define a set of command that you wanted to execute as part of the pipeline. So those you will define in each job level as well. One thing to note here, since we discussed that stages can be a collection of jobs, it means that you can associate two or three or multiple jobs with a single stages also. Okay, but you need to define the stage if you are defining the job. And under the stage, you should also have a script. Now let's discuss the component of a GitLab YAML pipeline, or you can also call it as a keyword. So these are some of the keyword which we use in the YAML pipeline, like workflow, variables, before script, stages, jobs, and script that we already discussed here. There are a lot more keywords available, but as a beginner, we should at least know this component or a keyword. Okay, so let's start understanding all of them one by one. Let's discuss the workflow. Workflow in a GitLab YAML pipeline helps to control when and what pipeline to run. So assume that you created a pipeline and you want to run that pipeline on a specific condition. Then you define the workflow and then you define the rules. So in this syntax, if you see, we are defining the rule that if the commit happens in a master branch and if the changes happen in a specific project, then only the pipeline gets triggered. So this is not a mandatory keyword. If you don't define that keyword in a pipeline, whenever there is a check-in happens in your project, the pipeline will get triggered automatically. But this is more on like if you want to control your pipeline, when to run, when to execute, right? Then you define the workflow. Coming to the variables, here we define all the variables which can be used during the job execution. Like assume that you want to set some variable, or maybe you are seeing some value that is being used repetitively. In that case, you define a variable of that, and then you can use that variable in your all the jobs. So with the help of variables keyword, this is how you define the multiple variables. Okay. So now let's discuss the before script. So this helps to execute any script you want to execute before the job script executes. So whenever we define a job, we define a script, right? Under that script, we define a list of commands or execution. So before that execution, if you want to run some specific command, like maybe setting the environment variable or something like that, Then in that case, you define a before script keyword and you write or add all the command that you wanted to execute. So this will first execute it, or you can say that whenever the job runs, it will execute the before script, and then the main script will execute. Okay. Now coming to the stages. So this is one of the important, or you can say that the must to have in your pipeline. So with the stages, we define list of stage, which will be part of the CI/CD. So assume that whenever you are setting up your pipeline, you understand, right? You need to set some stage, like you need to set a build, you need to set a deploy, you need to set a test, or maybe performance test, or maybe deploy to test, dev, QA. So those you can always define in the stage section. Right? And this also defines order of execution. So whenever you define the stage, you can also define in an order. Like first, whenever we create a pipeline, first we do a build, right? And after the build, we deploy it, and then we'll run the test. And after that, we'll deploy it to the test, QA, and then staging, and then to production. So all the sequence, you can add it in a stages keyword, through the stages keyword, basically. Now coming to the job. So we can define multiple jobs, and each job must be part of the stage. So this is a very important thing, that whenever you define a job, that can be associated with multiple stages, but at least any job, at least it has to be associated with the one stage. Without that, it will throw an error. I'll show you that in the demo as well. Script. Through the script keyword, we define all the list of command that you wanted to execute as part of your pipeline or a deployment or a build. So here, if you see in this section, under the job, under the stage, we have defined the script to display some message, and then MS build to just build your Visual Studio project. Now coming to the schema of YAML, like GitLab YAML pipeline, you can define first the variables, stages, the jobs, and the jobs you define which stage it should be run. And then under the stage, you'll have a tags where you define the GitLab runner. I will also add the reference of my video, how you can set it up your own GitLab runner in the below. And then we define the script. Under that script only, you define all the set of command or step that you want to execute as part of the pipeline or to execute as specific to the job. Now let's see the demo for the use case one, that is setting up the multi-stage and multi-job pipeline. In this sample YAML, if you see, we have defined three different stages and three different jobs, and each job is associated with the one stage. So whenever we define a job, at least it should be associated with one stage. Right, you cannot have without, and then we, under each jobs, we'll define this script, right, where you define all the set of instruction or command that needs to be executed as part of the build. So let me go and edit this, and I will just try to delete it, everything whatever we have, and then I will start. So as per the instruction, first we need to define the stages, right? And since we are setting up the multi-stage, multi-job pipeline, I'll just define the build, and then I'll define the test, and I will define the deploy, right? And after that, we will define the job. So I'll just define the build job. So this job will basically execute for which stage that you need to define, like this is for build, and then we need to define the tags. Tags is making sure that this pipeline runs on a specific GitLab runner. So in my case, I have installed the GitLab runner with the tag Windows runner. Windows runner. And then we will define the script here. So here I'll just print that right host. So now this completes the setting up three different stages, but we have defined only one job under that. So let's define a few more. So just I'll copy paste, and this name is already taken, so I'll just maybe let's run job, be something with and then it will also use the same stage. Run job. I'll create another job which I will associate with a different agent. Test, and then test. Okay, so once I commit this, since we didn't define any workflow rules, so it automatically, the pipeline will get triggered automatically, and it will run this. For a three, I think it will mainly run for two stages. We didn't define the deploy, and two jobs is for one stage, and one job is for, let's define this for the test, and then I'll commit. Okay, we'll see that execution. Okay, so let it run. So if you notice here, we have two different stages, build and test. Under the build, we defined two different jobs, and under the test, we had only one job. In the third stage, we did not define any job. That's the reason it's not appearing. So if you want to see that also, let's edit that, and meanwhile, we set it up. Like, assume that I want to create another job which will help to deploy package. Deploy. And then I will mark it for a deploy stage. Right, and I'm in a deploy. So now with this, we have defined three stages, and also we defined a multiple jobs. And at least one job is pointing to one stage, right? I'll commit it. I'll go to the pipeline. Let's see if it's triggered already. Okay, yeah. You see now, you also see the deploy now, because we created another job which is pointing to this stage deploy. Okay, so that's all for this use case. Let's go to the next one. Now let's discuss the use case 2. In this use case, we'll set up a pipeline with a variable. So in some of the case, whenever you set up a pipeline, there is some variable that needs to be configured as part of the pipeline execution, so that you don't have to hard code the value again and again, because the same value or a variable can be used in multiple jobs and in the multiple steps as well. So in that case, we use a variable, and you don't have to do anything. You just need to define with the variable section. And assume that for demo purpose, I just created a variable called a deploy path, and that I will use in a script session. So in this YAML, if you see, we have defined the stages, and under the build job, we are trying to just display that message. So you can maybe make use of that variable. So first you need to define the variable with a name, and if you want to use, just you need to use with the dollar and with the name of the variables. So let's go and see in that pipeline. So I'll just set up I'll just edit this file, and I'll remove all of them, and I'll just copy from here. Okay. So with this, if you see, we have defined a variable called a deploy path, and it is has a value, and we define multiple stages, and just we can have also, it's not that, but we have only defined at least one job, and that job is associated with at least one stage, right? So that is a mandatory for any YAML pipeline. So I'll just commit this. So now I hope it all would have already triggered. Let's see if it's getting executed. Yeah, it's running. So if you see, we just use one YAML only, one job only. And if you see, it is printing that the variable value here, if you see. So we just, because in the script we define the variable, and that was a like dollar deploy path, and it is displaying the value. So this is how you can use the variable in a GitLab YAML. Coming to that use case 3, where we need to build the Visual Studio project. So it's also the simple. We just need to define the stage, and under the script, we just need to use the .NET. So yeah, I'll just try to show you. Already I have one sample project called a Visual Studio solution file, and I'll just edit this. The only thing I need to change is the tag, because I have the underscore. So if I complete this, so if you notice here, this is one of the built-in variable. This is a project directory. Under that, we have a solution file. So it will build this solution file with the configuration of release. and you can see this. One thing you need to make sure that whenever you use the GitLab runner, that GitLab runner should have a Visual Studio, right? Then only it will build the Visual Studio project. So currently it is running and it got succeeded. So let's see whether the Visual Studio build got succeeded. Yeah, I can see this DLL got generated. So I think that's all for the demo. So this is to, if you want to learn how to set up your own GitLab runner, you can just go through this tutorial, and this is for demo. Thanks for watching this video. I hope this will be helpful. If you have any issue or concern, you can write in a comment box. I will be happy to help. And if you like this video, kindly share and subscribe to my channel. Have a good day. Bye-bye.